During initial days, BCCI didn't have enough money. They promoted cricket in India by paying countries for foreign tours and TV channels for broadcasting this sport. Doordarshan used to force BCCI to pay 5 lakhs for every telecasted match. The 1983 Indian World Cup team was supposed to get just 7,500 rupees from the entire World Cup series. Indian cricketers never even imagined in their wildest dream that they can be financially free in this profession. But then, it all changed. April 2nd, 2011, I was glued to the TV screen, and with me, the entire India's eyes were on the final Cricket World Cup match against Sri Lanka. It was the night like never before. It was like the appearance of Diwali in the month of April. People cracking fireworks, offering prayers regardless of the religion, and the whole nation came together to celebrate the World Cup victory drought of 28 years. This much craze for a single British invented sport, I asked. Why are Indian players one of the richest sports celebrity in the world? How does India has the best players, the best league, the richest board and the muscle to dominate the world cricket in spite the country being relatively new to the sport as compared to its England and Australian counterparts? To understand Indian cricket and its evolution, one needs to look at the performance not only on the field by the players but also the performance off the field by the administrators and the BCCI. These two parallels on and off the field is what makes Indian cricket great. The world domination of Indian cricket didn't happen through a single event like 1983 World Cup victory but a series of such similar big and small events. BCCI was formed in 1928 at Delhi Club to end the British monopoly in the game. The responsibilities of BCCI from then has now changed to commercializing the Indian cricket, deciding sponsors, deciding Indian cricket fixtures with the other countries, managing foreign tours and player stay, providing player salary, and also deciding on the TV broadcasting rights for the matches played. It's a fact that if it wasn't for the BCCI, Indian cricket wouldn't have been such a success. But the Indian cricket to take off, they first needed to break the chain of multiple administrative problems such as internal politics, corruption, conspiracies and non-serious attitude of ICC towards Indian cricket. Moreover, on the field, Indian cricket performance till 1983 was average at the best. Even the 1983 World Cup victory came as a surprise to the entire cricket community. The performance of India could be considered by the fact that before 1983, India played 210 test matches, out of which only 35 matches were won, which is just 16% of the overall test matches played. So the performance of Indian cricket, both on the field and off the field, along with the advent of colour television in India pretty late, until 1982, acted as a bottleneck for the popularity of this sport in the country. To top that, Indian cricket was not financially strong. Well, at least not till 1990s. The players played cricket but also went to a day job at Tata's, SBI or Air India to meet their expenses, indicating cricket was played as a hobby and not as a profession. Cricketers rarely did advertisements back then, and even if they did, the payout was very less. Then what changed? The early 1980s were a tough and violent period. Rising militancy in Punjab, massacres in the northeast and riots in the other parts of the country. Indira Gandhi's prime ministership was under question, haunted by corruption and license permit raj. India was a nation under siege and was looking for some inspiration to lift the spirit. Cricket provided that magical moment of hope in times of despair. 1983 didn't just change the Indian cricket, it changed the entire country. Suddenly, we had a renewed self-belief as a nation and people started accepting cricket as a major part of their lifestyle. But the financial condition of Indian cricket didn't change, as the board was still paying 5 lakhs per match to Doordarshan for telecasting it on their channel. It's similar to the BCCI creating the content and then paying Doordarshan to showcase that content, and Doordarshan getting rewarded for the content by the public as the content was widely accepted. Doordarshan was profitable on the both ends, and the Indian cricket was in huge loss. Only until 1993, when the board decided to take the television rights away from Doordarshan and sell it to TWI, an entertainment company. The irony is that Doordarshan was then forced to pay $1 million to TWI to telecast the cricket matches in India. This was the first time when a good amount of money was pumped into Indian cricket, and then they never looked back. Jagmohan Dalmia is one of the most important faces who steered Indian cricket's meteoric rise to a commercial sporting power. Previously, all the World Cups held in England until 1987, when Dalmia forced ICC to play World Cup outside England for the first time in history. The host countries were India and Pakistan. Under his leadership, BCCI made $600,000 in revenue for the first time by selling TV rights away from Doordarshan to TWI in 1993. He also led India, Pakistan and Sri Lanka host 1996 World Cup, gaining huge profits at the time worth $10 million from TV rights and $12 million from sponsorships. Due to his contribution to the game, he was made first ICC president in 1997. During 2000s, the Indian cricket caught the actual fire. ITC Hotels, Sahara, Nike, Star India, Oppo and now Baiju's have been sponsoring and paying hefty amount to BCCI for keeping their company's logo on the Indian cricket shirt and also sponsoring players' cricket kit. The advent of IPL in 2008 added fuel to the fire by making IPL one of the most popular league in the world, right next to NFL and NBA. This league was started as an idea in the mind of Lalit Modi, who then turned it into a multi-billion dollar league and the biggest source of income stream for the BCCI. Currently, BCCI earns around 3,000 crore every year, with 67% of it coming from IPL and 25% coming from India and other countries' bilateral matches, while the rest coming from India's shares of ICC revenue. The popularity of cricket in India is also fueled by the sheer size of its population and also the emotion regarding the game, which runs deep down in their hearts. In the coming years, Indian cricket is just going to flourish and climb higher due to the passion of the Indian population and profits for the big corporates, who will do anything in their power to make it a global success.